If you print your documents, not just on a desktop printer, but commercially on a digital or offset printing press, then you probably know that the colors that you see on screen look different than the ones you get on paper, sometimes really different. And so when it comes time to choose a color, like I want to make this text some color, and it's not any of the colors I currently see in the swatches panel. So I'm first going to click this little T icon up here at the top. That means apply the color to the text, not the frame itself. And then I'm going to hold down the Option key or the Alt key and click on the New Swatch button down here. That forces InDesign to open the New Color Swatch dialog box. Okay, now what do I do? I know that I want to choose CMYK from the Color Mode pop-up menu here, because I want to restrict the colors to only those I can print, right? So that's good. But now, how do I choose a color from down here? A lot of people just move these sliders around until they see a color they like. But then they're horribly disappointed later because, just as I said, you can't trust the colors that you see on screen. So if you can't pick a color by how it looks on screen, then how are you supposed to pick a color? Well, the answer is use a CMYK swatch book. For example, I use a True Match Color Finder book. It looks kind of like this, and you just flip through it until you see the color that you want, and you can grab the code number here, and then use that code number in InDesign or Photoshop or whatever. Or, honestly, what I usually do is I just write down the CMYK values here. Like this is 55% yellow and 33% magenta and so on. Then, back in InDesign, I could come in here and choose the True Match library down here and then just type that code, or because I know the CMYK values, I'll just type them here. Like that was 55% yellow and 33% magenta, so I'll type that here. And then I'll type 25% cyan, and it was only 6% black. There we go. That's the color that I was looking for. And, you know, this works because the book lets me see exactly how this combination of colors looks when it's printed. Of course, colored ink looks really different on uncoated paper versus coated paper. So there are CMYK swatch books for coated stock, like glossy or matte paper, and a different swatch book for uncoated stock. Now, of course, if you're printing on newsprint or colored paper of some sort, then obviously the color is still going to look different. But in general, it's still better to choose a color from a swatch book than grabbing something that just looks good on screen. Now, there are a bunch of different swatch books out there. True Match makes one. Pantone has them too, of course. And we're going to put links to all those books in the notes below. Whatever the case, make sure you get a printed swatch book. And make sure it's not too old or has been sitting out in the sun or something, because the colors can fade over time. And remember, when you're choosing CMYK colors, trust what's already been printed, not just some color that looks pretty on screen. Okay, well that's it for this episode of InDesign Secrets. Be sure to check out InDesignSecrets.com for thousands of InDesign articles and tutorials, and sign up to receive our free weekly InDesign Tip of the Week. Thanks for learning with us.